Hey, yeah, I know. Welcome to the whiskey section. This is not a whiskey video, I know. I just had to, you know, kind of just make a quick update on my gear that I got here. First off, I have my Godox, my SL 60 watts, yeah, just here next to me. And it's on 20% right now, and it's amazing. I love this light. It's definitely an update to my studio, and I have my Canon M50 right in front of me here with the Rode. It's the Rode VideoMic Pro, not the Pro Plus, just the Pro. This is a nice setup. The only problem is that the Canon came, I guess it was a mistake from their part, without the kit lens. And I was actually going to use the kit lens to make my videos. So I had to buy something else because I know the kit lens is going to come on at a later time. So I bought the 22mm Canon. That's what I'm shooting on right now here. And it's amazing for the blurry background and everything, but well, it kind of crops, you know, it's a 22mm, that's all it can do. So I can't really get close to the camera with my whiskies and stuff, and it has to be a very, very big picture for me to get there. That's the only downside right now. I'm waiting for the kit lens. I'm going to get the Sigma 16, but right now I'm just waiting for the kit lens to be able to make better videos for what I'm doing with my whiskey stuff, where I can show the bottles and not only my head like right now. But anyways, I just wanted to let you know that I have this update on my channel. I know it's not whiskey related, I'm sorry about that, I hope you don't mind. But this one, you know, and we have the auto focus here. No, but really, you have to see this if you can. Have the Godox, amazing, amazing light right here next to me. It's the 80 centimeter version of the softbox and the 60 watt SL60 from Godox, and I'm pretty pleased. The talk I hear about people being able to hear the fan in there, it's true. I can hear the fan, and it does show on my videos as well. I guess I have to figure out something about that, but really for me it's not a big problem. It's not a beauty contest when I do my whiskey videos, so it's okay. It's okay, I can live with that, really. It gives a nice light, really, really pleased with that. It's only, as I said, at 20% right now. It could go to 100, and that's a lot. And then I just have my fill light over here. That's my old ring light, where I used to have my webcam inside and shoot my old videos. So yeah, I'm pretty pleased with my new setup, actually. I'm going to put in a link below. I'm not affiliated or anything, but if you're interested in reading something, maybe on Amazon, on the Godox light, on the Canon M50, amazing little thing, and maybe even on the Rode microphone. I know there's a Plus version. I didn't get that. I'm not going to. The only difference actually between this one and the new Plus is on the Plus, it turns off by itself when I turn my camera off, and it has chargeable batteries. But really, that doesn't mean anything to me. I can turn the microphone off when I turn off my camera. There's a light on the microphone, so I can see that it's on, and I can simply just turn it off. And yeah, about the battery, there should be thousands of hours of recording time on that one. So really, not a problem either. It's true, it's kind of hard to get to the battery. It's a bit fiddly job, but it's possible, and you can save some money on buying the older version. So the Pro and not the Pro Plus. I'm going to throw in the link down below as well. So, anyways, that was just a quick summarizing of my new equipment here. I'm going to try and make it look good somehow with my whiskey and everything. And I hope that you whiskey guys won't leave me for making a video like that. Maybe I can kind of, you know, inspire you guys to go out and get some new stuff. You can see the prices on Amazon and the links. It really hasn't been that expensive for me to do this, so I think it's a nice upgrade for, yeah, kind of cheap. So, that was all. Have a nice evening.